Hi, I'm Mark Renshaw. Welcome to stage 13 of the Tour de France, and what a stage we had. 192 kilometers finishing in Saint-Étienne, and it was indeed a breakaway that took the victory today. We were all hoping for a sprint finish, but in the end, seven riders breaking clear. Two from Trek Segafredo, Quinn Simmons, with his teammate Mads Pedersen, who eventually took the win on today's stage. So much is going to happen. We've got a lot of crashes. Let's have a look who fared well, who didn't fare well so well in today's stage. And there it is, the crash from Caleb Ewan, and what a decisive moment on today's stage that was for Lotto Soudal, losing Caleb Ewan to a crash like that. He took a really heavy fall, he fell down on his left-hand side, took him a long time to get up off the tarmac, and we could see that he was really in pain. One of his teammates has gone straight on in this corner, coming too fast, didn't envisage that it was gonna turn so tight. The rider in third position here, he's unclipped his foot and he's turned in really tight. Caleb Ewan underlapping the wheel, not able to react quick enough, takes the wheel down and he goes hard on his left-hand side, hits his shoulder, his side of his leg and his head quite hard on the tarmac there. That was a big crash. Wow, that was another magical save in today's stage. The rider from Team Bike Exchange, Jaco, he was able to hold it up. He grabbed a handful of front brakes that lifted the back wheel up off the ground, skipped it back inside, and he was able to save it. That would have been a really high speed crash if he would have went down at that point. And here we can see just 13 kilometers to go and Team Bike Exchange Jaco, they finally pulled the pin. They decided to stop their chase. It wasn't gonna happen today. Michael Matthews swinging off, stopping the work. It all came through over the radio. That was it for the day. And here it is. Here was the decisive moment from today's stage. Mads Pedersen, a blistering attack on this short climb. He was able to draw out the two other strongest riders in that group, and that was Fred Wright and Hugo Heuel. He showed he had the legs today, powered away. He picked just the right moment to attack. A lot of guys were on the back foot, but he had the best legs. Took a big gap straight away, and it was only those two riders that could come across to him. As we approach the final 700 meters of today's stage, it came down to these three riders, Mads Pedersen, Hugo Heuel, and Fred Wright. And as you can see, Hugo Heuel, he puts it on the right barrier, constantly looking over his shoulder. Mads Pedersen, his second wheel, he's in the perfect position here. He knows he's got one rider in front, one behind. He's able to keep everything in check. He waits for the perfect moment. They come around the last corner here with 350 meters to go, and Mads Pedersen can sense the victory. He knows he's the best sprinter in the group. He's a world champion and he can run top five in bunch sprints in the Tour de France. He jumps at 250 meters to go, and unfortunately, Heuel and Wright, they don't have the power to go with him. He easily takes 15 bike lengths straight away, looks over the shoulder. He knows this is victory, it's in his pocket, and it came down to some great teamwork from his teammate Quinn Simmons, and by far the most powerful sprinter in that three-up sprint. He's been trying to get in breakaways all Tour de France. Finally, he's nabbed one, and you could tell by the emotion as he crossed the line that he really wanted this victory for himself and Team Trek Segafredo.